Alright, so hello YouTube, it's Al Gettleson back again. In this video, I'm gonna tell you all my favorite stories of these eight bracelets I have right here. So we're gonna start with this one. So this one is a yellow and white tie-dye bracelet. And it's printed, it's rings and Rangers. So I got on the bus this one morning. This was back in my 12th grade year. Like a month before I went to Universal. And I, get on the bus and I saw this laying on the floor. I thought it was like a rubber band. And I picked it up and it was a bracelet. So yeah, I picked it up and it's a good part of my collection now. So here's another real special. It's probably one of my most favorite stories. This one, I know it's kind of hard to see because I, as you guys can tell, I don't have the flash on. It says Royal Caribbean International. Have a nice day, even though it's all blurry. But I'm not going to worry too much about that. Oh, there we go. So yeah, what happened was this one night on the Royal Caribbean, when I went last year, there was this little like game where couples dance and whatever the couples were gothies. And it's like I wanted one, so I knew I wasn't going to get one, of course. But then the following morning, I think, it might have been the following morning, or maybe it was a couple of days later, I think, I had sat down, I went up to a breakfast at this buffet that they have on the ship at the top deck, and once I got my food, I sat down at just a completely random table, and I looked over by the window. On the ground, there was, like, this wooden leg, and this was laying here, it was laying there like that. And so I picked it up, and I was like, oh yeah, I finally got one. So I got my own Royal Caribbean International bracelet. And, so this one, I got in Jamaica, if you guys know, from my old videos that I deleted, Margaritaville. So what happened with this one, actually, my red one too, but I'm not showing that in this video, because that one had pretty much the same story. So what happened was they had this Margaritaville store in the port of Jamaica where my cruise ship was, and they had a Margaritaville store. So I was like, oh, I wonder if they have anything good in there, any bracelets. So I went to the cash register, looked down to my left, and I saw this one. But the best part about the story was it was the last bracelet there. So yeah. So I picked it. So I bought it. Actually, I have that one now. I wanted to. So this one next. So this one, let me start with this one. So the orange one after. So this one I got, about three years ago, I did a Target run. I bought a Target figure. I bought Tito Santana, WWE. And I decided to come home on this road called Ehrlich, looking great right near me. And, midway coming home, I found this on the side and picked it up, and I found another one. So yeah, I have found a lot of these, so I have found a lot of bracelets. I'll do a video of that at some point, too. This one's story similar, too, but, a little bit different. It did involve my bike. So this one, I was coming home from somewhere. Oh yeah, I had, folk rehab meeting, and then I went to Publix to get some dinner. And then coming out of Publix, I was going home in my mom's car, and saw this on the side of the road. And so what I did was, when I got home, I got my bike and just rode back over to Ehrlich, which is where this was, and picked it up. So I got two bracelets from Ehrlich that I found. So yeah. So then at church, I had a friend who went to Paris. Came back and came up to me and my mom and another friend and said, oh, I saw something in Paris that I could not pass. And she had this hiding behind her back and she showed it, and it was a Paris rubber bracelet. My favorite part is the Eiffel Tower. And I like the Eiffel Tower. I've always wanted to go to Paris, but I don't really have the money for it. So, gonna do this one. This one says a chef's life cooking bracelet. So in my senior year, I had a culinary arts class for homeroom. And a couple months later, I was looking straight at a table and I looked down and saw this laying on the floor under the table. And so I picked it up and I was like, yeah, I got my own self-life bracelet because I've seen other people that had, other students in the school that had these, but I knew nobody would give one to me, so, yeah. So I picked that one up and found it, and then this one I traded one of my Mad Power of Youth bracelets, which is that one right there, the one that's in Power of Youth. And I traded that one of those for this one. It doesn't say upward, I mainly want it for the stars, because I've seen this one before in the school, so I wanted it. And last but not least, this is my most favorite bracelet in my entire collection, the DC Cruise Line Maxi Band, the second Cruise Line bracelet I got. So what happened was this past December, I was on the Disney Fantasy, and I wanted these Maxi Band, one of these Maxi Bands, because it had the ship on it. I didn't really care too much for the Mickey, but, and it had the Disney Cruise Line logo, and I tried everything in my book to get one. I couldn't get one because these were only for the kids, not for the adults, and even the adults could not buy one for themselves, which sounds pretty weird. So I got one, and actually I snuck one, but that didn't last long. I ended up telling my parents, and they made me return it, you know, to the front. So I told them that I found it, and that I snuck one. But yeah. And then for my birthday, I found one for cheap on eBay, so I got it for my birthday. So yeah, this was my bracelet video of my bracelets that had my favorite stories. So yeah, I'll upload this next week when I'm with my friend Ivan, and I won't make any more videos till then, till I upload these videos. So yeah, I'll upload these four videos, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.